I made a mistake. My sisters brought my chair. My chair normally has a pillow. The pillow was left here. So I come home with a pillow. And I got a pillow here in my room, which is my pillow. So I got somebody else's pillow. And somebody who, I don't even know what the deal is on that. Because the pillow belongs to somebody. But they didn't, it was in the shower room. And obviously nobody was, well, it wasn't where it was supposed to be. It was supposed to be on somebody's chair. And it's a big pillow, so it had to be somebody large. So when I was there, there was only one other person my size on the floor. So I don't know if he got this pillow, or if this is a pillow left over from some other time. I know I'm really sad about it. Wanted to find out they didn't have my pillow. But how was I to know when my chair disappeared for 11 hours? You know, so it was an honest assumption. Yeah. In order to get them to act right, though, I had to bring in prepaid legal, which I got a jackass from them, too. He kept asking me questions like, are you sure you blah, blah, blah? And he said, well, I'll call him. And he started talking about the alleged this, that, and the other. And, his language was very prejudicial. And I never did get to tell him, but I started to tell him, your word skills are prejudicial to your client. You know, first of all, he didn't come on the phone professionally. You know, he's doing the kind of, you know how a lot of white guys think that the way to get along with brothers is to do the easy, slow thing. You know, trying to be jazzy. It always does it turn me off. You know. And when we got to the end of our relationship, I think he understood, like I told him. He was talking about how, you know, was there anything else? Well, he was trying to talk me into signing some papers that I didn't want to sign. And if they were all right, I was considering signing them. But then he let something slip. I don't know if he slipped or he just didn't know what that would mean to me. He said, these are internal documents. Well, I did tell him. I said, notice there's no form number on these documents. He said, that's because they're internal documents. Well, I said, well, of what benefit is it to me to sign these papers? One of them was a promissory note. And then he started talking about what it did for them. And so, since he didn't answer my question about what it would do for me, I told him, I said, well, thank you. You did what I asked you to do. I'll take it from here. So he said, I wish you the best. And I think he got to drift it. You could find me woefully inadequate. Goodbye, jerk. You know. Anyway, he got me enough information. I knew what to say to me. I did not sign the papers. One of them even made a threat against me, talking about we don't want to have to do AMA. And I said, what's that? Against medical advice. If you go against medical advice and you leave someplace anyway, apparently Medicare or your insurance company will not pay for your visit. Man, they tie you up in all kind of ways. And I just didn't pay no attention to that. Yeah. So it's a tough, you're riding a Bronco.